Hello, I'm Chris Menard. In today's Excel video, I'm going to show you why I love pivot tables. This video is created for you to follow along with me, so please start Microsoft Excel. We're going to do a lot of stuff, but what I'm trying to do, the end result, is I want to know for whatever year I'm picking, 2023, 2024, 2025, I don't care. I want to know for each month, how many Mondays are in that month, how many Tuesdays, and how many Wednesdays. And so we're going to set this up from scratch, and then the pivot table will give us our answers. I'm also going to do at least four Excel functions. Two of them are going to be date and time function, and one is going to be a text function, and the other one is formula text, which I love to use when I'm in training mode. So start Excel. The only thing that I've done is type the word date in A1, day of the week in B1, and in C1 is month, and I also selected them and made them bold. So catch up with me first. And then we're going to go to A2. Another cool trick here. I'm picking the year 2024. You pick whatever year you want. 1/1/24. I happen to know that the year 2024 is a leap year, because it is divisible by 4, but it is not divisible by 100. So I know that's a leap year. So I could autofill this down to get to 12/31/2024, but let's use Excel's fill feature. And I'm also going to show you how to quickly select a range using the keyboard. So make sure you're in cell A2. Make sure that 1/1/2024 is there. We want to pull up Go To. You can pull up Go To by pressing the F5 function key. You can pull up Go To by doing Control G. You can also pull up Go To with the mouse by going to Find and Select Go To. And by the way, it says Control G. I am going to press the F5 function key. Use whatever method you want to. I'm in A2, A1 is my header row. I want to jump to A367. That'll give me the 366 days. But I want to select this. So don't click OK. You need to hold down the Shift key on your keyboard. Don't let go of it. Now click OK. Let go of the Shift key. You've got A2 to A367 selected. Home tab in the top left, I want to fill down the rest of the dates for the year. Fill, series. This is also cool. Because we have A2 to A367 already selected, Excel selected columns instead of rows. It also knows that cell A2 is a date, 1/1/24. Just click OK and you're done. There you go. Let's test it. Click in cell A2, put your mouse on that bottom border, but not autofill. That is autofill, the crosshairs. Put it anywhere else on this bottom border and just double click, and that will jump you to the last cell. And I hope it's 12/31/2024. I peeked down there and it is. To pop back up top, put your mouse on the top border and double click, and you're back at the top. That was pretty easy, but it was also pretty cool that we used the Control G or F5 to select, and we used the fill feature in Excel. Now let's get into some functions. So this is actually required to do this. I want to know the day of the week. So January 1, 2024, is that a Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday? What day of the week is it? The function to figure that out equals weekday. It's selected. I'm going to hit Tab. It's got one required argument, and the other one is an optional argument. We only need the required one. Equals weekday, open print, A2, press enter. I got the number 2. What that is telling me is Sunday is a 1, Monday is 2, Wednesday is 3. Watch this. So I should obviously get 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I'm going to just stop. I'm going to stop and sell B13 to be clear about this. So after the number 7, there's only 7 days in a week, it goes back. So January 7th, 2024 is a Sunday. Not required, but just to make this easier, go back to cell A2, Control Shift down arrow on the keyboard. Let go of Control and Shift. Number, the number group still on the Home tab. Feel free to make this long date just to prove it. Y'all know what happens when you get pound symbols. Put your mouse between A and B and just double click. That is auto fit. I'm going to do it again. Double click, auto fit. So Monday is the second day of the week. Tuesday is the third, on and on. There we go. So we can go here wherever you stopped. I happen to stop in cell B13, crosshairs, double click. To keep up with that, I'm over in cell E2, and this is where I like to put in formula text, just so you can follow along and see what formula I used. Cell C2, I want to know what month this is. We're going to use another date and time function, and it is the month function. One argument and only one. A2, I should get the number 1 here, and I do. Crosshairs, bottom right, double click. I'm just going to scroll down to make sure it's working. I'm not going to go all the way down because I know I'm going to end up with the number 12 down there. 12 months in a year. Perfect. In case you're wondering what I did in cell C2, there's B2. There is C2 for you. How about that? Looking good so far. But everything that I've done is correct. I just want to show you one other way before we make the pivot table. So I could make the pivot table right now, but I want to see, instead of the number 2 in cell B2, I want to see Monday, but I want to see it as M-O-N. If I wanted to see it spelled out all the way, I could. So to do that, by the way, this is about to change in just a second here. There is another function that I like to use. It is the text function. It has 2 arguments. Both are required. I'm going to take cell A2, comma, and notice it says format text in bold. How do you want to format cell A2? If I wanted to see, and I do, I want to see days, 1D would be the number 1. 2Ds would be 0-1. 3Ds is going to be M-O-N abbreviated. 4Ds would be Monday spelled out. So I just want 3Ds. Make sure you put that in double quotes, please. You don't need to close the print. That'll do it. Do a control enter here because I know I want to stay in cell B2. So control enter leaves you in the same cell. Crosshairs, by the way, there's the function that I just used. Crosshairs, double click. So now you could change easily this formatting over here if you don't like it. It doesn't matter. Just leave it. Okay. Same thing I did with the day of the week. I'm going to use the text function again, but I want to figure out the month. So equals text, A2, comma, D is for day, Y would be for years, but I want to know months, double quotes. 1M would be a 1 because it's January. 2Ms would be 0-1. 3Ms is going to be J-A-N. 4Ms would be January spelled out. I just want 3. Double quotes, press enter. Yep, perfect. Crosshairs, double click. I'm going to scroll down just a tad to show you that the months changed from January to Feb to March to April, on and on. I'm going to get rid of this over here right now. Hopefully, if you follow along, you already got it anyway. I'm going to delete it, right-click, and delete. Here is why I love pivot tables. I know this has taken a little while to get here, but I'm in training mode. But in real life, I'd have had this done in 90 seconds, 2 minutes at the most. So here we go with the pivot table. Click inside your data. So don't be over here where it's empty. Click inside your data. Insert tab at the top. Pivot table. Don't hit the arrow. Just click pivot table. Excel is smart enough to pick up your entire range, including your header row. Your header row has 3 fields, date, day of the week, and month. It's going to put it on a new sheet. Look in the bottom left corner of your screen. It says sheet 1. When you click OK, you're going to have another worksheet down there. Click OK. There is your header row over on the far right now. I want to take month and drag it and drop it into the rows filled area. I want to take day of the week and drop it into the columns. And I'm going to take day of the week again and drop it into the values. There you go. So 366 days. Now, if you're wondering, hey, can we fix this sort over here, right here? I want to see January through. Sure. You come in here and click. Go to more sort options. More options. Sort. I turned this auto sort off. I forgot about this feature. And then I want, look, my months are three letters. So I'm going to do J-A-N, F-E-B. Now click OK. Click OK. There you go with your pivot table. Shrink that column down. Actually, just I'm going to do a little manual formatting here. Just pull that out just a tad. How about that? So now you know in the month of August, for example, there are four Mondays, four Tuesdays, four Wednesdays, on and on. Pretty cool? I think so. I love this type of stuff. That is the power of a pivot table. And we also did that little sort feature, which I forgot all about that we ended up doing. Feel free to subscribe. Feel free to ring the bell. Put any comments you have down below. I hope you enjoyed this video and have a wonderful day. Thank you.